Hi guys, welcome back to I Know We Said No More Barbies. We're feeling a bit like a
flat.
I think we're like, this is what entertainers feel when they've like got to go and perform when they don't feel like it.
I don't know how they do it. I have an off day. I was just having an off day. Stay in bed.
I'm in the same bed as well. I woke up and I was like, oh, in a little bit more time. Anyway, yeah. So we're a bit late today. What time is it? 11 a.m.
Oh, God.
We're a bit late. Mm. We're usually doing it first thing in the morning. Cracker sparrows. Dawn's crack.
Oh, like the time there was a kookaburras.
Yeah, exactly.
When the kookaburras thing is when we're recording.
Yeah.
We're really getting into it.
Come on, let's get ourselves. Okay, we're here now. Now, so today's a fun episode. We're doing a few little changes today.
Yeah.
Because it's all a learning process, it's a work in progress. You know, we're adapting and we're evolving and it's a part of the journey.
Yeah.
That you're a part of, guys.
Oh my God.
So we are scrapping the categories top shelf and bottom shelf Barbies.
Mm-hmm.
I do like, I mean, mostly it was just for canvas. Like, I like, you know, having top and bottom right now. Just for, you know.
But then also, like, none of them are bottom shelf.
None of them are bottom
like,
shelf Barbies.
It just feels really mean to call a Barbie bottom shelf Barbie.
Exactly, when none of our Barbies, I mean, there are bottom shelf Barbies, but we don't have any.
We don't know them.
Except the ones with flat feet, gross. Oh, I've got the squeegee here. Oh well, sorry about that, guys.
I'm thin today.
No, this is the squeegee. Let me change it. So today we're having our new categories, and that is iconic Barbies and underrated Barbies.
Oh, underrated Barbies.
Oh, still fabulous. Everything's fabulous, but you know,
they just don't get the dues. Some of these underrated Barbies just don't get the dues that they truly deserve.
And you know, the Barbies, underrated Barbies that we never heard of, that we get and we're like, how the bleep did we never have these or see these? Anyway, so.
Facts. Literal facts.
So today's underrated Barbies are Barbies that inspired the ballroom.
Totally.
We saw these Barbies for the first time last year, and you can see a little clip of that on our video. We made a ballroom for Barbie.
Oh, that is a tongue twister.
That is a tongue twister.
We made a ballroom for the bar.
Peter Pickle, pick up a bit of a bit of a bit of a bit I can't speak normal English, let alone tongue twisters.
Oh, God.
So, we saw these on the internet. We saw the ad of them, and we had no idea. We never knew they existed. They're called Dance and Twirls Barbie, and they are remote controlled. And when we made such a huge fuss about getting them, a lovely woman on Instagram named Katie Zay, she so generously gifted two of them.
So she messaged us and she was like, I can't decide whether I should get you the AA Barbie or the blonde Barbie. And then she was like, you know what? I think I'll just get you both.
Yeah.
So she sent us both, and they came in like the most humongous boxes.
Fabulous boxes. The packaging is fantastic.
Mm.
And remember how upset she was? She was, because we realized when we got them out that we needed batteries. We didn't think about that.
Obviously it was the 90s, batteries not included.
Obviously. Yeah, and so she's like, oh my God, I'm so sorry, I'll send you batteries. Like, oh no, we can, don't be silly, we buy our own batteries. you've been so generous. So you don't have to buy us batteries and send them from America. So these are our underrated Barbies. Which we're going to start with, and then we're going to go on to our iconic Barbies, which are beautiful and just amazing, and we're going to get to them. And then for our unboxing, we've got a little treat for you, because we know how much you love the crafty stuff.
Totally.
You know, from that week, that video that's been out less than a week, all the feedback has been how much you've enjoyed the crafty stuff. So we're going to do some little snippets of crafty stuff in here as well, as a little, you know, extra tidbit. We have these Barbies, which we're going to unbox, which we'll talk about later, but they are Olympic skater Barbie and Olympic skater Ken. Oh, do you want to do your thing? Oh, we're so far away from the camera now, aren't we?
Olympic skater Ken and Olympic skater Barbie.
Yeah.
They have like beautiful backstories.
They do. So we're going to get to them later. That's for unboxing, and we made a little thing for them as well, a little play feature for them, which is exciting. We'll get to that as well. Okay, so let's start with our underrated. Well, not yet. Hold on. So let's start with our underrated Barbies. Or should we go? No, Liz, that's fine.
We go underrated Barbies.
Underrated Barbie. face.
Underpaid.
So we have Dance and Twirls Barbies. Mm-hmm. And they are both beautiful. They're both Barbies, aren't they? This isn't Chrissy. This is Barbie as well, isn't it? Or isn't she?
They are both Barbies. Barbie. Yeah.
They're both Barbies. They are from what year?
1994.
Mm-hmm. And they are just pretty fabulous. Oh, there is one thing about these dresses that I don't love, and that is this little part here isn't connected.
Yeah, the waist isn't quite cinched in the waist, but that's because when they twirl, exactly, it turns into a full circle, so you sort of need that open.
You kind of need that open, and we did have little plans of stitching that down, so it was really cinched at the waist, which we still might do.
But then when you do that, what happens is there's all the extra fabric at the front and not the back, so it doesn't
okay
full circle. Okay.
Well, we'll get to that. So they've got super long hair, as you can see, and it's straight, which at first I was not impressed about. I'm like, why has she got dead straight hair? But then once we started playing with her and spinning around, you realise her hair gets everywhere. So you need to have a hair that's easily managed, especially at that length.
So beautiful when it spins everywhere.
So this is AA Barbie, and she has the Christie mold, which I love. Oh, they got faceted rings.
Faceted.
Fascinating. let's give you a little look at their playfish, because it's actually like hilarious and just. So there is an on switch. A little on switch and a little lever so you can change the setting. And it's all run by one wheel on the bottom. This one here. And then these ones are like rotating ones, they're just a freestanding. So this wheel has to be, you know, that's the magic. So she slots in here. And the dress covers a little thingy.
It's actually so beautifully constructed in an A-line that it does actually just fall.
Yeah, it really
so
does.
Perfectly over it.
Okay, so we're going to flick the on switch.
Okay.
Okay, she's on.
Okay, I think mine's on too. Okay, is yours on one, two, or three?
Mine's on one.
Okay, I'm going to put mine on one, two. And we'll just see what happens.
Do they both go at the same time with the same remote control?
Yeah,
they do. Okay. Oh!
Oh,
Where's mine going? Is it on?
That's on now.
Oh! Like, oh!
Okay, so I think one is the spinning around one.
Okay.
Okay, you ready? Okay. Like,
I'm even scared of it.
Right?
Oh, it's a nice breeze, actually. Oh! Oh! Oh!
Just had enough.
Okay. Oh, I love these. I actually.
Oh, she's.
Yes. Oh, ridden hard and put away mounted.
Okay. Okay. One more time. Oh, is it losing it? Oh! I want the remote control. Give me the remote control. Okay. I trust you. Okay. Okay. Ready?
Okay.
We haven't done this for ages.
No.
Oh, fell off.
Oh, it's on her. Okay. Okay.
Whee! Okay.
Oh my god.
Okay, should we do something fun now? let's just put it on a different setting.
Okay.
I'm seeing two.
I'm gonna choose three.
Okay.
And we'll just see what happens.
Oh my god, I'm so scared.
Because they just like. Yeah, okay, go.
Okay, ready?
Oh, no.
Oh my god!
Oh. Everyone's gonna do that.
Everyone's gonna do that.
Oh. Oh god.
Oh, it's ours. It is ours of fun.
It really, honestly, really is. Oh, and look, their dresses have come down. Oh god.
Oh, jeez.
Boobs are out. God. This is actually like really super hooked me in.
Yeah.
I'm like really excited.
Yeah, this is good. This is a good one to start with. Like I say, every episode we're feeling flat, we play with these birds. Yeah. Okay.
Oh my god, they are just so fun. She just ran at me.
Okay, what are you on? I'm on three. You're on three. I'm on two. Let's go back to one because it's just one's the only one we can do on this surface. Okay.
Okay.
Should we do a little, we'll do a slow motion, okay? It, providing that this one's successful.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah,
slow motion. Are you ready?
Yeah.
So as you can imagine, I'm assuming that these would have been trashed if you got them like when you were a kid. Like you would have been like on the street.
Knocking into furniture.
If I had this when I was a kid, we had carpet the whole house. Yeah. Except the bathroom, the laundry, and the toilet. Like even in the kitchen, we had carpet. It was like old 70s carpet. Yeah, it was weird. It was gross. So we would not have been able to play these on any surface except the driveway or the bathroom. So I don't feel like I missed out because I feel like if I had them, I'd just be really disappointed that I couldn't play with them the way I wanted to.
Totally.
Well, if my sister had them, because I wouldn't have had them. What time? When did they come out? 94.
94.
Oh yeah, I was way too old by then.
You're like 16.
Yeah.
Did I just do that right?
You did do that right.
Nice.
I wasn't too old to play with Barbies, but my sister was definitely too old to be bought them. Mm. So we would never have had these anyway. Which is a shame. But in a good way, because it meant that we got to enjoy these as adults. Yeah. As if we were children. Trust me, we feel like children when we play with these. Just when we play with these. I feel like a mess every other time, but a child will play with these.
I love these dolls. I love their dresses. I love everything about them. I love the iridescent. I love the pink.
Yep. They are
original.
Gregarious.
What does that even mean?
I have no idea. what are they? Let's find a really good one for them.
Yeah.
Kissable.
Stand by. Oh. No, I'm already
playful.
Well, yeah.
Duh.
Breathtaking.
They are breathtaking.
Yeah.
Dynamic.
Because they can do different things.
Yeah,
they
are dynamites. Like, dynamite! Okay.
So this is what inspired our ballroom.
So thank you, Katie Zay, for this wonderful, wonderful gift. It was so generous and so beautiful. And it just was so unnecessary to buy us two. But we loved it because we both got to share the joy together, which is really nice.
Yeah.
And
it's a shame that they can't go in the ballroom.
They're not going to like. You know, you've seen this. We can't trust them. They're unreliable.
Trust them.
I know how it feels.
Same girl.
We're not going to put them in the ballroom. I mean, there's no point. Like we know. There's just too much can go wrong. That ballroom's held together with hot glue and a prayer. Like literally.
You saw. You saw.
It's a what's it called? It's a display. Okay, yeah. These are our underrated Barbies, Dancing Twirls Barbies
from 1994.
Oh, so where are they made?
Oh yeah, that's a really good question.
Because their paints are really good. Their paints are lovely. Yeah, their paints are. Yeah, she's got a beautiful paint. Has she got a beautiful paint?
Yeah, she does.
Yeah. Yeah.
The little like starburst in the eyes.
Okay, this one was made in.
Mine was made in China.
China, yeah.
Oh, fabulous.
Okay. Thanks, Katie Zay.
Thanks, Katie Zay.
You put that down there for me.
Hours and hours of fun.
Okay. So now we are getting to our iconic Barbie. Okay, go again.
Iconic Barbie. You're just doing it to get on your nerves.
Iconic Barbies. So, this is a really wonderful moment in our I Know We Said No More Barbies.
Definitely a series highlight.
Series highlight, yeah. This is Black Barbie. Now, she came out in 1979. Well, she was made in 1979. She came out in 1980, officially. Yeah. So she's almost as old as I am. So that's pretty amazing. And she was the first Black Barbie. Mm. So previously, we've had Christy.
Christy was came out in 68.
Yeah.
But the first Black Barbie was
Francie.
Coloured Francie, I think her name was called.
That was her actual name. Yeah. So previously, Barbie had black friends.
Yeah.
But Barbie wasn't black. And then in 1979, or 1980, Kitty Black Perkins, who was the first, I read this last night, African-American designer Mattel ever employed.
Wow.
Yeah. And she designed Black Barbie. This isn't Christy. This isn't Francie. This is Barbie. And Barbie is now black.
Yeah.
How beautiful. Now, they have used the Steffi face mold, which is one of my favorite non-Barbie face molds. I just think it's a beautiful face mold. And later on, they did change Barbie to have her own mold, which they used for the Christy mold, which this is the Christy mold, and this is still Barbie.
Yeah.
I found her online last year in America on eBay, and she was actually pretty reasonable. She only cost $50 American, new in box. She's been sitting in her box for 40 years.
Wow.
Yeah. And it was a deal of a century. Like, it was like, I couldn't believe it. So I grabbed her straight away. I think she'd been cost more than what she did, to be honest. Mm. But she arrived and she was just so breathtaking. Like, I just, honestly, yeah. Like, it's just, there is some, she, like, magnificent. The only way I can describe her is magnificent. She's absolutely,
she really is.
Just so empowering and just so beautiful. And it's funny, I forgot to mention this last week when we got when we did our Crystal Barbies.
Mm.
And AA Crystal Barbie was the first black Barbie I'd ever seen.
That's true, yeah.
Like, as young kids, as young Caucasian kids, well, you're half Caucasian,
yeah.
Our sisters played with white Barbie dolls, like blonde Barbie dolls.
I have to be honest, I was really ignorant. I didn't even know that black Barbie even existed all throughout my childhood.
I didn't either.
None of my friends had any
I don't ever recall seeing any in the toy aisles in Australia, where we're in the suburban areas we grew up in. Like,
even to find a Barbie that didn't have blonde hair was like... You have a Barbie that's a brunette?
Sometimes they were mostly just brunette Barbies with a Barbie face. They weren't, you know, Barbies of different ethnicities. So it was a real pleasure because we got a little bit of quite a few comments when we first started our Barbie collection because we were embracing and recapturing our own youth when we didn't get to, we've told this story, but when we didn't get to have our own Barbies. And so this whole process was us reclaiming that lost youth.
Yeah, and getting to have the unboxing experiences that we never got to have as children, getting to play with them brand new.
Yeah,
and
owning them ourselves because we only play with our sister's Barbies, you know. So when we started the Barbie collection, people were commenting the fact that our collection was all white.
Yeah.
It was all Caucasian, it was all blonde Barbies. And for us,
It didn't register.
It didn't register for a little while because we're like, well, no, because we're collecting Barbies from our childhood. And these are the Barbies that we played with and that we wanted as kids. And then we obviously, you know, started to diversify. And the first Barbie that wasn't white that I got was Crystal Barbie.
And it was
Crystal
like Barbie. It was actually a true pleasure and a joy to discover like a whole new facet of Barbie in our childhood that we didn't even know existed.
Yeah.
Like, it was just actually really, really enjoyable to, like, embrace this whole new element of Barbie that I'd never seen before. And
yeah, and a new standard of beauty.
Totally.
Because when I saw Barbie with dark skin, I just had never seen anything so beautiful in my life. Like, I was just, like, mesmerized by them. And so, I mean, to be honest, I don't love
Crystal Barbie.
Crystal Barbie's face. I don't like that mold. I'm not a fan of that mold and that paint. But then we got Black Barbie, and she is just so perfect and so beautiful.
And the way that the outfit is constructed, because when I was a child, I used to look at Barbie's clothes, and that's actually what taught me how to sew. It was like a really simplistic version of sewing, of just how pieces of material went together. But to see this and the construction of this outfit.
It's so simple, but like, look at the back.
To be completely backless.
And the way the fabric folds, it's just made so beautifully. And like the gathering here at the front to give that slightly bat wing feel. I know you can see this, so we're just explaining what you can see, but you know, this is the part that we love about this Barbie. And all the rouging here, and her skirt comes off, and she's got, oh, should we take her skirt off? So she's got her.
Oh my God, do it.
You know how I love a swimsuit.
We both do. We love a tearaway.
Love a
good tearaway. Like,
isn't that just heaven? That's magnificent.
Can you even?
I know. We'll put this back on.
Yeah, when she came into the house, it definitely was a huge turning point.
It really was, yeah.
Because she just, she looked so powerful and in charge and
she is
strong. And she just gave this whole new element to our collection that was like, We need more.
Yeah. And she instantly became my second favorite Barbie. Well, up there with Loving You. She was always next to Loving You.
She is still.
I always had her, like, you know, like when we were playing with her. And she sat, her and Loving You sat on my desk for a long time because I just love looking at her.
Mm.
So this is Black Barbie from 1980. Have you got her box? Let's find out what she's made.
I do have a box. She is made in Taiwan.
Okay. Mm-hmm. We still haven't figured out a pattern. Anyway. No. Anyway, I love this as well. Where's her thing? Oh, doll needs support to stand.
Don't we all, darling?
But she comes with a little pick. Instead of a Barbie brush, she comes with a pick, which is, I thought was really, really cute. So this is Black Barbie from 1979/1980. And she is absolutely one of our favorites.
Yeah, she is an iconic Barbie. If ever there was an iconic Barbie,
If ever there was. And then we move on to our next iconic Barbie, which is a very new addition. We actually just opened her up
yesterday.
No, the day before. I think it was the day before. So I have been wanting to have our beautiful First Nations sisters represented in our collection for a long time. But we don't have. There are a lot of Barbies of the world, but there are no First Nations, Indigenous, Australian Barbies. And so I really wanted to, as I said, have them represented, but I knew to do that, I would have to be a bit crafty and come up with something myself.
Yeah.
So to make sure that I was being culturally appropriate, because obviously we want to be, you know, we don't want to be offensive. I did contact two of my beautiful First Nation sisters, Felicia Fox and Tyra Bankstown, just to sort of make sure, just to run it past them, that would be okay and appropriate if I created a First Nations
inspired
Barbie, so we can have them represented in our collection.
Yeah,
I went through and I did a bit of an investigation. I looked at a lot of Black Barbies and Christies and Barbies with dark skin tones. There's a whole new collection of amazing new Barbies, and they've got their own face sculpts, which is just wonderful. So I settled on the 40th anniversary Black Barbie reproduction. So this is a new interpretation of Black Barbie, and she's the 40th anniversary. So with a few minor crafting adjustments, I did a little searching on eBay and got a few supplies. And I knew that I kind of wanted a dress that would represent the Indigenous flag, which is black on top with a yellow sun and a red ground, a red bottom. I added a nice little beaded sun and a black feather boa. And now we have our beautiful, beautiful First Nations people of Australia represented now in our collection.
Yeah. And I do love that you say a few minor adjustments as if it was really easy, because you hand stitched all of these beads on.
Oh yeah, we can show you. We made a video, a crafty video. Okay, let's insert the video here.
See, like, a few minor adjustments coming from you. The hand stitching everything on.
Yeah. Well, originally, well, by the way, thank you for that great segue to that video. That was perfect. you're getting so good. So these are our beautiful, iconic Barbies. We're going to really work on that.
Yeah.
We're going to do some rehearsals.
Should we do one more?
Okay. What are we going to do, though?
I like it when we scream it out loud. That's fun.
Okay, cool. Okay, and these are our beautiful
iconic Barbies.
Yeah, that's good. Yeah, that's the one. Okay, yeah, we're gonna lock that in.
Yeah.
Make a file and bank that. Put them on the hard drive. Okay, now we're up to unboxing.
Woo! Oh, that's nice. Yeah, just full, nice, high pitched.
Yeah, nice. Melodic. It's really easy on the ears.
Turn your TVs down.
So we got this Barbie here, and she came as a gift from a lovely, lovely lady named Rowan, and she said a beautiful story. And she is obviously Olympic skater Barbie, and she's from
1998, I believe, the Olympics.
Wait. Oh yeah, 1998. That's right.
1998.
Well, she 97. Well, she's out of our window. It's 1977 to 1996.
At a push. But this is a big push.
She's still got the superstar face though, so it's fine. You know. So do you want to read out the lovely backstory that Rowan?
Oh, I can't even with this backstory. I wanted to send you a present. Both of you bring so much joy on a daily basis, and I really wanted to make a contribution to the Barbie house. I know you don't have an ice rink.
Well, Rowan.
But to be honest, she's retired anyway. She couldn't get back to the heady heights of her 1998 win at Nagaro, so she spiraled into a terrible coke habit. And I think the Barbie house is the best place for her ongoing recovery. Just keep her away from birthday in the kitchen. I just think that's so fabulous that not only did she get us a Barbie, but she gave us
a backstory
that totally fits in with the theme of who our Barbies are as people.
Absolutely. And if you don't understand what the kitchen reference means, let us show you a photo of the kitchen now. and see if you can guess why she said stay out of the kitchen. And I feel so embarrassed because we found her quite recently-ish, in the last couple of months.
Yeah.
Still in a box, behind the Barbie house, underneath a lot of other boxes. And we're like, oh my God. Oh, we forgot about her. What do you mean? What is this? And so, and even after how beautiful the gift was and everything like that, when we got her, we're like, oh, that's amazing.
That's amazing. We'll unbox her and it's definitely going to be a thing. And then we pop her aside.
I contacted Rowan and I was like, oh my God, we just found your Barbie. Like, I just, you know, that's, I'm so sorry we haven't opened her like that. But did I thank you? She's like, and she assured me, she's, yes, we thanked her. But it was just after I came out from my middle surgery.
Right.
And I was completely delirious and high on endone. So we weren't really in a position to be recording and to opening Barbies and stuff like that. So she sat in a box till now. Yeah. And then she has this amazing play feature, which we'll get to. But Ken picks her up.
Mm.
And so when we're doing God's Word with Carla, we decided that we would find Ken.
Yeah.
And there can be a set. So we found Olympic skater Ken, and he was $10.
Oh, Ken.
Oh, I know. His box is a bit damaged, but that's fine. The boxes don't mean anything to us.
Really interesting face.
Yeah. So let's unbox them.
Ta-da!
This box looks easy. After last week's trauma, I am not doing that again.
Didn't you cut yourself?
Yes, I was bleeding. Now, there's instructions on this Barbie. This Barbie has instructions.
That seems like way too much work.
I see what it is. Oh my God. She's gonna... I'm really excited for her now.
Oh, do you want a spot?
No. You get to play with a two.
Okay, good.
There are a million cable ties in here. Literally a million.
It has a million. He has the most strangest hair. His hair is so weird.
That's rich. God, I'm exhausted.
Did you just break her skates?
Ah! Oh, her band broke.
To skate or not to skate.
He doesn't want his midriff showing while he's dancing. She's fabulous.
Look at those feathers. Glamour, glamour, glamour. She is just the height of glamour. Which the pointy thing goes at the back.
I don't know. I'm not a scientist. I didn't realise they had stoppers on ice skates.
How do you think they stop?
Oh, she... Ow, ow, ow!
Give her a hammer. She can go full Tonya Harding.
Hold lever down to lock position, then wind Barbie up.
Help me.
Oh, honey, I've got my own thing to do. Okay. Do they come with instructions?
It's all right. I don't brush my hair either.
You're going to want to see this. Wait. Ready?
Oh my god, that is so... Oh okay. My god, okay, we have to...
Put him in there.
Come to me, Barbie.
Oh, he can be... Russian?
He's Russian to get her in his arms.
Yeah.
I honestly feel like this is gonna, like change our lives. Yeah.
Oh, she's going. Well, I wouldn't say life-changing, but like, it's still fabulous. Ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Oh. Oh, you're right, he dropped her.
Oh my god, his skate's broken. Oh my god, he broke his skate. They are not winning the Olympics.
No wonder she's a cocaine addict. She's like, she dropped her. These are Olympic skater Barbie and Ken. From 1998. And they're made in Indonesia. Well, she's made in Indonesia. Their boxes are absolutely trashed.
Yeah. And he was made in China.
So we did a little bit of crafting yesterday and we made a ice skating rink, which we'll show now. Thank you so much, Rowan, for them. For her. They're gorgeous. And thanks to Carla for organizing him to be shipped over. They're actually beautiful. They're beautifully made. The costumes are fantastic.
Yeah.
There is a few issues with the joints and the play feature.
Yeah, he's real.
Yeah, I mean, I think if you have a Barbie that is designed to be held and spun, Ken should be strong enough to spin her, right? And support her.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I don't see many more golds in their future.
No. They definitely peaked in 1998.
I think he's let the team down, to be honest. Mm. Yeah. And so that was episode 5 of
I Know We Said No More Barbies.
Now it's very exciting because we are monetized. We've made, as of last night, $47.
Shut the
front door. We've only got a couple of videos up.
Oh. Guys, thanks. Actually, that's really nice of you.
Yeah, I mean, we've only been monetized for like less than a week. Oh, so, you know, I know it's very early days, and let's hope that we make more money than $40. But it's just the beginning.
Because I want to quit my job and be a YouTube star. With you at my
job. That will be your job. So, don't forget to flick the subscribe button, guys. Flick it. Yeah, flick it if you like it. Comment if you like it. Like it if you like it.
Totally.
Because all this happens in the first 24 hours I've learned of the algorithm. And if people appear to be liking it, then YouTube promotes it and sends it out.
Oh, I love that.
Yeah, so the algorithm will work in your favor, but it's got to happen in the first 24 hours are very important. We know that it's been very Barbie heavy lately, but that's because we're cutting our teeth on Barbie, which is a nice little fun way of learning YouTube, because it's actually really, there's a lot of things.
Oh, actually, speaking of comments from before, we love reading all of the comments, and so many people have mentioned Winking Western Barbie as their, you know, Barbie that they remember from their childhood, which we have in our collection, and she will be featured in an upcoming video. But yeah, keep those comments coming.
So guys, thank you for joining us again. It's been an absolute pleasure, and it's so much fun. I hope you enjoyed it, and we're gonna see you on Tuesday.
Mm.
Yeah. Bye.
Bye.